All right, so here's where we're at. If we run this little program, we've got our cool looking form. It's probably a little excessive on the height. I don't know that it needs to be that tall. Maybe we ought to chill out on the height. So maybe we'll make it 600 across so we can get the two names, but maybe we'll only make it 200 high. What about that? Just see what it looks like. And I can, by the way, make it appear on the screen where I want to, but I don't want to go into that in the example. Okay, so we're going to check the compatibility, and then we're going to get the result onto the label. Okay, so now we got to set up the event for this. So I'm going to go in and create again. It's an inner class, so it's going to be a private class. Class inside our outer class. This is the end of the regular class. And this is the end of the, well, that's actually the end of the create contents, right? If I scroll up. And then we have our constructor here. And actually, I probably ought to do a better job in general of commenting. This is where we set up frame and options. And then we're going to build the contents. And then down here is we're going to add the contents. Okay, so that's what we've done so far. And now we're going to create our action listener. So again, private class, I can call it whatever I want to. I'll just call it listener. Now that's probably not good. So I'll say check listener for the check button. And that's going to implement the action, whoops, action listener class. Okay. Well, in order to do that action listener, it's not going to be able to find that symbol. I have to go up and import the java.awt.event.*library, and that will bring in the events classes. And then remember that I need to do a public void action performed is the name of the method. Now this one again, I do have to name it exactly like that, and I'm going to get an action event passed into me, E. Now we didn't talk a lot about the action event, but it's going to tell us what event occurred, where it occurred, different types of information about that click that happened or that button that was pressed or whatever the action is. Okay, so the action that I want to perform in this case, we'll worry about that in a minute, but let's add this listener that we've just built. Actually, I'll just do the same thing. So I'll say system.out.println. So I'm just printing the console and I'll just say testing to make sure this is working okay. And then what I want to do before I compile that is go up here and add the action listener. Okay, so I do that again by saying, what do I want to add it to? Well, I want to add it to the button, so I'm going to say button check dot add action listener. And which action listener am I going to add? Well, I want to add an instance of the check listener. So I say new check listener, opening, closing parenthesis. And not only, by the way, I mentioned before about using, if you're going to use it for more than one method, you could create an object for it, and then, or more than one element of the form, you could create an object for it and then attach it to multiple. But that's not the only thing. If we want it to be the same check listener, so if different actions, like let's say we're adding one every time the user does something, and it's whether they click the button or press the enter key. Well, then I want them to be attached to the same action listener, so it's using the same object to update that. Anyway, okay, so I associate that. Now, if I compile that and then come back to my game driver class, I'll run this, and when I click check compatibility, then it should print out testing, and it does. So we're getting an action when we click on that button. That's good. Okay, so what we don't want to do that. That's not our action. We want to decide on whether these two names are compatible or not. And because I am, if you'd seen my dating life, you would know that I'm not an expert on dating by any means. And so I have no real formula for, we could build a formula if these names do this or if they, you know, whatever. But we're going to do it the way I like to do it, randomly. Okay, so we're just going to build a random number generator and generate a random number. And depending on what the number says, then we're going to talk about their compatibility, okay? We won't tell them this, of course. But I'm going to build a random number generator. And the random number generator, so random r equals new random opening closing parentheses. Now, this isn't going to work because I need to import the Java util. I haven't done that yet. So import the java.util.random class. Okay, now it will work. And then once I have that random number generator, then I can generate a random number. So I could say, give me an int I, I'll just call it int result, and just set it equal to 0 to begin with. And then I'm going to say set the result. So this isn't, let's say it's all up to fate. So that's what I'll call it instead. I'll call it fate. Okay, so we're going to determine fate here. This is not random. This is being controlled behind the scenes. And we're going to set fate equal to r.next int out of, let's just start out with two different options. Okay. Once I have that option, I've selected the option, then I can say, let's go in and if the fate is equal to a 0, then I want to set the label to say you are compatible. Okay, the label result, I believe, is what we call it. Label result. We don't have results, it's just result. I don't know why I put results. Let's see if I did it up here too. Okay, I'll take the S off that just because it's bugging me. The result that we're getting, if fate equals 0, I want to go into label result, and I want to set the text. How do I do that? I can't just say equal to. That doesn't make any sense with an object. There is a set text method, so I can set the text equal to you are compatible. Actually, we got to make it something, you know, like love is in the air. And if that fate roll comes out to be a 1, then we can say label result dot set text equal to that's not love in the air. Something like that. Okay, so let's try running this and see what happens. Okay, I get an error. Cannot find, label results. I took off the S and that messes everything up. Okay, so that compiles okay. We run this. And so we can put in two names. This is always dangerous. There's my name. This is my wife's name. Come on, baby. Uh-oh, big trouble. That's not love in the air, it's telling me. Okay, so aside from having to break this news to my wife, this looks pretty good. It's working pretty good. If I check compatibility again, oh, there we go. Love is in the air. So if I keep checking compatibility over and over again, then that will give me my random number, and And that works pretty good. Let's check here. Who can we check? A famous couple. Brad Pitt, Angelina Jolie. Check compatibility. That's not love in the air. See, we're not getting good luck here with this label. Now, this label is not really in the place where I want it to be. I would like it to be on the line below, but since I'm using this flow layout, it just puts it automatically there because the check compatibility button isn't that big. So I can modify the form to have it be how I want to, but we're getting a result based on what's been entered. And so that all happens by attaching listeners to objects, like in this case it was the button check that we were attaching it to. And we can attach multiple, we can create multiple listeners to do different things and then attach them to different buttons so that the form can perform other actions. And otherwise, this is just like a Java program. We can set variables, we could keep track, and we could put a check in there. So, for example, I ran it again and again and again with the same names. We could put a check in there and that wouldn't allow them to do it if the same names are in the box. And so I could create a temp one name and a temp two name, and then read those in. The way we read in text is to get text. And so instead of the set text, we can use a get text to read in the text. And we can have them enter in numbers with the get text. We can convert them. Everything that we did in other aspects of Java can be done in this GUI, these GUI aspects. And but it's just the only difference is instead of having it be a well, two major differences. It's GUI instead of command line, but then just having it set up and then waiting for events to happen. I set this form up, and I wait for the user to... In fact, let's just write a simple check here. It will check compatibility if, even if there's no name. So before I do any of this, I could say, let's have an if statement that says, before we determine any fate or do any of this, let's back that up. I'll say, if text name one dot equals blank. So if it's blank, then I can put a label that says so label result I could set to say set text and say missing name number one else if text name two dot equals a blank then label result dot set text missing name number two. And I suppose I should probably have a name one and name two, but otherwise then we can do all this stuff. So I'll grab all this all the way down to the end, tab it over one, and then come in here and put that result. So now if any of the forms are blank, oh, gotta have semicolons. I'm sure you guys saw that. Just let me go on looking like a fool. All right, so now if I try to check compatibility, Spencer, and I don't have a second name, then it didn't work. That's a minor problem, right? Did I set text or get text? All right, we'll go ahead and stop there and just finish this example up in the next video. Fix this problem. Spencer out.